Here's the Quick, the two-man English group currently having Australian success, interviewed now by Nikki Horn in London and Molly via satellite.
Hello to Colin and George from The Quick. Welcome, lads. Now, why haven't you done any gigs?
Well, it's purely a financial thing.
It's so
difficult, so expensive to gig over here at the moment. And we spend most of our time in the studio, and that's costing us a fortune, I can't tell you.
How long have you been together as a band, then?
About 2 years, I suppose.
About 2 years.
And success has taken a relatively long time, really.
It has, yeah. We're not exactly an overnight sensation.
So what can we look forward to next from you?
Apparently there's an album coming out pretty soon.
Right.
A new single, hopefully, about a month's time, I suppose.
Yeah, about a month, 6 weeks.
Group to have success in 1981.
Now, the Bureau formed out of Dex's Midnight Runners. Can you tell us how, you know, the Bureau in fact started from that?
The Bureau really is a direct result of a very strong promise we made with Dex's Midnight Runners quite a long time ago. And we said that we'd never stand still, never repeat ourselves, and we'd always continue moving forward and be in a position where we could offer something new and something interesting all the time. We felt that we had to split with Dexys and form a new group and able to continue doing this, you know, when it got to a certain point. So that's just what we did, really.
And do you feel that the music that you're now making is substantially different from the stuff you were doing with Dexys?
I'd like to think it was a logical development of what we were doing with Dexys.
Visage have made another enormous impact with Fade to Grey. Here's Steve Strange talking with Nikki and Molly.
Well, with me in the studio this afternoon is the man who, more or less single-handed, has started the whole romantic movement, Steve Strange. Hello, Steve. Thank you for coming in. I understand that you don't actually like the term new romantic. How would you describe this movement?
Well, basically, I realise that people have to have a label with the press and things, but that's the only reason why they've labelled something to it. I'd rather call it the cult with no name, because all the time it's hopefully going to move on and change.
I must ask you, Steve, who thought of the concept of that film clip, Fade to Grey? Is it one of your own ideas, or was it a collective idea?
Well, the way we work with Kev and Lowell is that we all sit down and storyboard an idea together, and with the help of in Fade to Grey, with the help of the makeup artist, Richard Shara, the ideas are all put together.